Welcome back, guys. We're continuing on this Union campaign and we're on South Mountain next. Now, this is just an offensive battle where we're just charging in trying to take the objective, so we're just going in with infantry somehow. Yeah, I forgot to save game, unfortunately, before when I reorganized everything, so that's why things look a little bit different. So I'm just gonna double check. Yeah, so we're just going in with the divisions that we've already got made up. We're not actually going to replenish any of these, just to try and keep the scaling as low as possible. So it's not a great mission, this. We aren't going to have the best KD ratio. All we have to do is take this objective. So what I'm going to do, because they've got loads of troops protecting it and there's a massive river, we're just going to flank with all of our troops down one side. We're not going to take the supply with us. I'm not even going to bother taking. Oh, go on, I will. I'll just leave him at the back. Okay, so we're just going to flank down here with everybody, and then we're going to make our way around and then take the objective. Now we are going to get flanked over here. As we're going up, people are going to come across and shoot us in the side, so we're going to have to leave a few divisions behind to protect our advance. So I think I'll probably just leave the ones that have been routed behind. So we can be the first one. Unfortunately, we're getting shot from this side now with this division, so he's getting flanked, which is going to make it harder for him to stay in the fight. God, I'm always so tempted by these supply wagons. Dealt with one of the cannons that are here. And we're gradually dealing with the skirmisher. So we've got another cannon just here. And then I think we've got another one just over here. Unfortunately, this Harper's unit's getting pretty much slaughtered. Somebody's got to take the heat, unfortunately. Let's move this musket unit across, see if we can get him to take the damage. I thought there was a skirmisher unit back here, but he might have flanked around. Nope, he is there. I thought he was. So we're just going to get into position. We've actually got quite a few units here. Don't particularly want to bring all my units out like that. I think I might do that instead. Unfortunately, I'm having a bit of trouble cornering this skirmish unit. Okay, we've finally dealt with that skirmish unit now. All we want to do is just keep this for until the contested timer runs out. Now, I don't know whether you have to wait until the whole battle timer runs out, or it's just the contested timer. But we're taking far too many casualties to drag this battle out any longer. If we wanted, we could try and do some damage to these units that are in the open, but I just don't think it's worth the risk. Okay, so it does look like we're going to have to run the clock out, unfortunately. Yeah, I knew this was gonna happen, him getting flanked by this cannon unit. That's why I didn't really want to do this. Yeah, now we're gonna get flanked down here, so I knew it wasn't worth the push down here, but we did do it. I regret it. I was just trying to alleviate the pressure on these units. But it definitely wasn't worth it. Well, as you can see, we took considerable damage there. We did more damage than we took, but that's far too many casualties for my liking. But there isn't any real decent way of playing that mission without taking huge casualties. Or at least not that I've found anyway. So we captured a few pirates. Not too bad. That's not great. We lost two officers. One of them was a Brigadier General. We got two wounded. So, not great. But we got the victory. Okay, so we're in for a big one, Antietam. So, it's going to take a short while to set up all of our armies here. Yeah, we're in desperate need of officers.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we need a 2-star general. So let's just take this one.
Sir, yes, sir.
Looks like I've already used him for ammo. Don't particularly want ammo, but that's what we've got on this guy. It's not the worst thing in the world. It's just I usually prefer the experience. Right, so let's put all the cavalry in the 4th corps. I've actually cocked up there. I could have got a free colonel. My bad. Okay, so we've got a cult there, another cult there, and then we've got the sharps here, which I was only using temporarily, really, until I had some more melee weapons. So we'll sort the cavalry out at the end though. So I'm going to need 5, 10, 15, 20, 21 it looks like. Have I lost a unit? Oh, I disbanded one to be able to shift things around. So I'm going to need 21 more divisions. Now, it's going to take a while to organise all this stuff. Because I switched everything around for that mission. Yeah, it's going to take a very long time. So let's move all of the muskets out and all of the random weapons. Just put them into this 3rd corps. And we can put all the harpers back into the 1st corps just while we're sorting out the guns, and then we can sort the cannons out afterwards. Okay, so we've got one that we haven't moved across. Right, this battle is a long one. Let's check the armory out first. So I'm going to want these. I might want the parrots. Yeah, I think I will. I'm going to want the melee weapons. We've still got access to Harper's Ferry, which is nice. We can actually buy all of them. That's marvellous. And then what have we got up here? Well, that's crap. £10 of Barrett's Ordnance and Napoleon's. What type of shop is that? Or government? 7,500 of them for 18, though. That is good. Before, it was like 2,000 for 7, which would be 4,000 for 14. So that's almost one and a half to two times as good. So that might actually be worth taking. Let's have a look, see how much 7,500 is in terms of cost. So 190,000. 190,000 for 18. That's well worth the cost. So I think I'm going to purchase them. Right, let's sort all these weapons out. I think, yeah, because this mission is quite a long, bloody mission, I think I'm going to go for 1,500.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we've got enough armory for one more division, it looks like. I'm only going to be able to have 26, 27, so 1350 really. So this guy's got close to 1350. So is this one. Okay, so that's all of the Harpers sorted. So we could do with putting them in experience order, really. So he's the lowest. Take him out, and then I think he's the second lowest, so let's take him out, and then we can bump these up. This isn't exactly massively important doing this. I just like to organise it so when I'm giving the new guns out in the future, I'm giving them to the units with the best experience. Okay, that'll do. And then we need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So these lot are going to get relegated. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we've got a £24 Howie here, a £20 Parrot, £24 Howie. £20 Parrot, £24 Howie, £20 Parrot. I think we've got one here, £24 Howie, and I don't think we've got another £20 Parrot. So we need to find one to swap the guns, so it's likely him. Form line. Yeah, so he's the highest experienced. Unfortunately, we've only got six. So I might just have to put it on. It's £24 Howie. So just so I've got a mix of Howie and Parrots, I'm just going to bump up the £10. Let's see what we've got. So we've got the six 20 pounders, so I might make a small division of that. Then we've got quite a few of the 10 pounder parrots, so I could make three divisions, and then I can make one division of ordnance, and then if I wanted I can make a division of these small Howies. I'll come back to that afterwards. So for now, we just need two more infantry divisions in here. So we've got some Texas, some Springfields. So I'm going to do the Springfields first. Let's move him up a second. Go on, let's move these two up as well. And then we just need one more division. So I could leave it at that, or I could just not worry about that little bit of extra efficiency and stamina and put it up to 1500. So I think I'm going to do that actually. I don't think I'm going to bother messing about with all of these. I've got another MJNG here. Yeah, they are quite smallish divisions. I think this should be okay though. Alright, so we got Texas here. So let's create another Texas. Oh no, we've still got Springfields that we need to do. We've still got these Harper's Ferries left over, but I think I'm just gonna keep them in reserve. So we've got 7,000 Springfields, so 1,500 will put me up to 6,000 with four divisions. And then we've just got 1,000 guns spare. So we'll see how we get on. We've got 30,000 troops. Let's have a look. So that's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's about 2,500 probably. So I need 27.5. So I need about 26,000 guns really. We are going to struggle with that. Yeah. So at the moment we've got 3.7. So we got 10.7. We need 26.5. We need like 17,000 more guns. We're not going to be able to afford 17,000, I don't think. Well, we can get these Springfields, that'll put us up closer to our target. But it's not going to quite fill out the ranks. Might just top it up with Springfields. I reckon that'll be fine. Then I can sell some of this stuff that I'm not using. We'll come back and do that afterwards. Okay, so next thing up is the Springfields. I mean, I could use these 1,100 guns, just spread them about in amongst these. Don't know why he's only at 1350. I obviously forgot to do him.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir!
Okay, we're looking all right. We're looking all right. Got another Harper's here. That's unfortunate. Should have checked that first. Too late now. Too late now.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right then. So we need some cannon divisions in these six. We haven't got any in here, so that's six more cannon divisions. Before we carry on, once I've done them six cannon divisions. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then we're going to want 9 infantry divisions. So 1 Texas, and then 8. So that's 1,500. So just over 1,600, I reckon. So I'm going to need to steal some of these. Officers.
sir.
Yes, sir.
So it's not ideal having these low-ranking officers, but there's not much we can do about it because we need them for the infantry. So at the moment we've got 1, 2, 3, 4. We need 9.
Yes, sir.
Didn't actually check to see if these muskets need any, which they don't. That's good. Okay, so we're going to need five more. So let's start off with these two. One, two, three, four.
Yes, sir.
Five. Oh, it looks like I calculated it a little bit wrong. I was 1,000 out in my calculations. Must have forgot to carry a 1 somewhere. Okay, so I could add 5 times 200 to these. Or 10 times 100. So I think I'll just add... I'll add 100 to each one. There or thereabouts. Okay, I think that's all of them sorted. So what we've got left, another 158. Okay, that's them sorted. So now we just need the six cannons on here. And then I think, we need to do the cavalry as well. So we'll do the cavalry next.
Yes, sir.
So we've ended up with another dragoon again, but
yes, sir.
It'll have to do until we can replace him.
Yes, sir.
Okay, I believe that is as good as we're going to get it. So we can sell some weapons to get the supply up. Okay, so I think that is as good as we're going to get it. I'm quite happy with that. We've spent all of our money, and we've got a few troops left over to replenish any cannon if need be. I don't think this battle goes on for more than one day, but just in case it does, we've got the extra troops left over. So we're ready for Antietam, I believe. Let me just quickly double check. Yep, everything's looking good. Okay, so in the next one, we'll be starting Antietam. So cheers for watching, take care, and I shall see you soon.